Beautiful there, isn't it? The Field of Light there, commemorating all those people, and done by Bruce Munro. Let's move on to the weather, which, having a look at the national forecast just now, I hadn't realised just how much snow could possibly even come south.
Yes, so there is a potential for some snow. We're talking about mainly Sunday.
It's a weekend,
Sunday
isn't it?
Into Monday, but there is a warning. There's an amber warning for the eastern part of the country. That's not affecting us, and we're not in any warning area.
Okay.
So we're more likely to see flurries, if anything,
okay,
at the moment. Let's take a look at your weather pictures. Jenny Monk took this picture of the flooded Charwell Valley.
Neil Harris photographed reflections today in Calshot. Very nice.
And Jason Selman sent us this shot of a surfer in the sunshine in Swanage. Today we had some sunshine finally after a pretty wet start to the day, with that band of rain slowly clearing eastwards, but showers did follow. This is a scene we saw, a little bit of blue sky in Cranbourne in Dorset, photographed by one of our weather watchers. Now tomorrow we'll see further showers, and they could be heavy and they could be thundery, more likely through the latter part of the afternoon when they'll become thundery. But generally the showers will move in during the morning, dry and bright at first through the morning with some mist and fog patches. Tonight any showers we had today will clear away. We're looking at clear skies overnight tonight, maybe some mist and fog patches which will develop during the early hours of the morning, and low temperatures for northernmost areas. Here there could be a touch of frost, lows there of 1 or 2 Celsius, but milder for the south coast. So through the morning tomorrow there could be some mist and fog first thing. It's a bright start to the day in many places, then the cloud will thicken through the morning and we'll see the showers move their way northwards across the patch. They could be heavy, they could be thundery, and they may merge together to form longer spells of rain, but temperatures will be mild for the time of year once again, with a high of 9 to 10 degrees. So on the inshore waters tomorrow, that's from Selseybill to Lyme Regis. The winds are southerly or southwesterly 3 to 5. The visibility is moderate or good, and the sea state is slight or moderate. Further showers are possible tomorrow night, but they'll tend to ease during the early hours of Friday morning. And under clearing skies, we'll see mist and fog develop once again, possibly more widespread than tonight, with temperatures falling to a mild 5 to 7 Celsius. So a pretty mild start to the day on Friday, but Friday is expected to be a little bit cooler than recent days. Low pressure's in charge of our weather. We'll see some sunshine, but this weather front may produce some showers, and they could band together, moving eastwards across the region, and they may be heavy for some. Not everyone will see the showers. There'll be some dry weather as well, with some decent amounts of sunshine. So here's the outlook for the rest of the week. Tomorrow we are expecting some showers which will roll in after a dry and misty, foggy start to the day. Through the course of Friday, sunshine and showers, maybe a cloudy start in some areas. Saturday, once again, some showers, and it's into Sunday that temperatures take a dip. We're looking at highs of 2 degrees, the chance of some wintry flurries in a few places, and the cold temperatures remain with us as we head into next week. If you'd like to send us your weather pictures, here's the email address, southweather@bbc.co.uk. Sally.
Thanks, Alexis. Now, we want your help to mark a special anniversary later this month. Do you remember this?
The new decimal money will be with us on D-Day. Decimal Day. The 15th of February, 1971.
Yes, it was the year we said so long to the shilling and ta-ta to the tanner. It was a big upheaval, not just replacing all the coins in circulation, but switching from a money system based on units of 12 to counting in tens instead. So plenty of room for confusion. But what do you remember of decimalisation? We want to know. Email us at south.today@bbc.co.uk, and we may use some of them on the programme.
Remember, the pound stays the same. Only the coins which make up the pound are changing.
So sixpence?
No idea.
Threepenny bits?
Sorry.
Florin?
No.
Half a crown?
Before my time.
Ten bob?
No.
You don't remember any of that?
None, sorry.
We're looking forward to hearing your stories about decimalisation, so do get them in as soon as you can. We'll have some fun with this. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.
Good night.